गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू श्री विद्या मंदिर हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल एंड वी आर हैप्पी टू इनफॉर्म यू टुडे वी आर स्टार्टेड ऑनलाइन क्लास फॉर 10th स्टूडेंट्स हु दे आर प्रमोटेड फ्रॉम 9th स्टैंडर्ड टू 10th स्टैंडर्ड इफ दोज चिल्ड्रंस टू यूटिलाइज दिस वीडियोस प्रॉपरली एंड आई विल होप यू टू स्कोर एस मार्क इन द 4th अकेडमिक इयर्स थैंक यू एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द बायो बॉटनी वन ऑफ द चैप्टर plant hormones presented by T. Sivagangan, Department of Botany. The today topic plant hormone. Then what is called a hormone? The hormones, it is derived from the Greek word. Actually, it's a Greek word means excite in the sense to elevate, to trigger, to induce the cell division and cell elongations of the plant as a result for growth or takes place. So that is why the word hormones means it's excite or also to inducing or triggering of the particular part of the plant body. That's called hormones. Actually, the plant functions of control and coordinations is performed by certain chemical substance which are synthesized by the plants themselves. These chemical substances are called hormone. Actually, it is a chemical substance. The chemical substance which is synthesized by the plants themselves in one part of the plant, they control and coordinations for the various functioning of the plant body. These are called plant hormones. But these plant hormone actually, they are produced very very low concentrations, very very low amount or low concentration in one part of the plant body, very very least amount or minute quantity in the one part of the plant body. But in plant there are several cells are capable of to producing these plant hormones, several type of cells that have capacity are capable that undergoes to producing this chemical substance which control various physiological effect of the plant body, several type of chemical substance. So actually these plant hormones are transported to the different parts of the plant body to perform your various physiological functions. What are the physiological function? The physiological functions such as cell division, cell elongation, as a result growth and development, so as a result to synthesize protein synthesis, protein and fat synthesis are takes place, synthesis are taking place. So these are the various physiological function is performed by this chemical substance. As a result of cell division and cell elongation, to increase the total weight of the plant bodies are gets increasing. A single cells are divided into two cells, 2, 4 and 4, 8. Likewise, as a result, they increase the mass of cells. All the dividing cells are gets elongated. As a result, growth are takes place. These are the one of the physiological functions. In apart from this, they induce flower formations. That induce fruit formation. In some hormones, they induce ripening of fruits. So these are the various physiological functions are performed by these hormones. We are going to discuss now what are the various physiological functions, how they are occurs and how they are takes place in the different parts of the plant body. In generally, these hormones are also called phytohormones. The word phyto means plant. Plants. Hormones means chemical substance. Hence, it is also called phytohormones. They are produced at a very, very low concentration in a particular regions actually,
and generally these are called organic molecules. Organic molecules. The what are the organic molecules composed of? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, then nitrogen compounds. So the phytohormones are chemically called as, it is an organic molecule. They are synthesized at very least amount or minute quantity or low concentration, but actually they are synthesized in one part of the plant body, but they are translocated to the other parts where they influence a specific morphological, physiological and biochemical changes are takes place. Let us understand, it's better to understand to take the diagram. It is a plant. It is a leaf. It is apex. So lamina portions are leaf. In generally, the plant hormones are synthesized at the tip of the plant. Either maybe shoot tip, leaf tip, or root tip also. They synthesize the tip of the plant body. I mean, they synthesize in one part of the plant body. From there are migrated, translocated to the other part, where they influence a specific morphological changes. Morphological or biochemical changes are takes place. Then what are some morphological changes? These chemical substances are synthesized in one part, they are migrated to the other parts, it causes loss of chlorophyll. Chlorophyll, it is a green coloring pigment present in the leaf. Due to the presence of a green coloring pigment, they perform photosynthesis. If some plant hormones or some certain chemical substances are, they are translocated to loss the chlorophyll molecule by the process called chlorosis. Chlorosis, in the sense loss of chlorophyll molecule, as a result turn into yellow color and ultimately shedding of leaf from the plant by the process called abscission. And also, what are the morphological changes that takes place? The green color leaf, it is transformed or changes into yellow color because of this chemical substance. And finally, the leaves are shedding from the plant body by the process called abscission takes place. So these are the morphological changes. And biochemical changes also takes place. What are the various biochemical changes? To synthesis of protein synthesis, lipid synthesis, fat synthesis, everything that takes place due to the presence of this chemical substance. These are the various morphological or effect is controlled by these phytohormones. Generally, the phytohormones are broadly classified into five major classes. There are five major classes of these phytohormones, also called hormones. The first one is auxin. Second, cytokinin. Third, gibberellins. Then fourth one is abscisic acids. It is also called ABA. Fifth one is ethylene. See, based on their origin and various physiological effect of these phytohormones are also called plant hormones, they are broadly classified into five major classes. The one is, first one is auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, abscisic acid, then ethylenes. See, the first three hormones, auxin, cytokinin, gibberellin, these are called plant growth promoters. Growth promoter. But whereas abscisic acid and ethylenes, they are said to be plant growth inhibitors. I mean, based on these functions, there are two groups. One is a plant growth promoters, another one is a plant growth inhibitors. This auxin, cytokinin and gibberellins, they are responsible for promote the growth of the plant body. So they are called plant growth promoters. How to promote the growth? By cell division and cell elongation. As a result of cell division, all the dividing cells are gets enlarged or elongated. As a result, growth takes place. So these are always called as a plant growth promoters. But whereas these abscisic acids and ethylene, it is always inhibit the growth of the plant body. See, in based on these major functions, actually these are the chemical substances which modify the growth, either may be promoting or inhibiting, but never gets depromoted. Once plant bodies are gets promoted, they never get depromoted. But these first three hormones are called only gets promote the plant body, especially the root tip, shoot tip, leaf promotion, leaf tip apex growth. These are takes place due to the process of these auxin, cytokinin and gibberellins. So they are called plant growth promoters. But these two, to inhibit the plant body, they never gets promoted. How to inhibit the plant body? By prevention the elongation of stem and root in longitudinal directions. How to prevent? By using certain mechanisms are used by these two hormones to prevent the plant growth. Hence it is also called inhibitor, but they never gets depromoted. So these are the major five classes. Based on the functions, there are two groups. One is a plant growth promoters, another one is a plant growth inhibitors. We will explain one by one. The first one is auxin. Auxin, it is the first plant hormone to be discovered. First plant hormone. Hormone to be discovered. It is initially derived from the human urine. I mean the patient of Bellahara patient of human urine. Initially isolated from urine of Bellahara patient. The Bellahara patient urine have the same chemical substance of these plant hormones, especially in auxins. So it is a first plant hormone to be discovered. It is initially isolated from the urine of Bellahara patient. And the word auxin means to grow. To grow. The word auxin, first chimer are introduced by. Word auxins introduced by Kojal. Kojal and Hagen-Smith. Hagen-Smith in the year 1931. Kojal, Hagen-Smith, the two persons first introduced the term auxin in the year 1931. But actually, the effect of auxins was observed by Charles Darwin. Observed. I mean, where they are synthesized, what are the effect of these auxins? In the auxins, they are always cause promotion the growth of the plant body. How to identify? It was observed by Charles Darwin. In the year 1880, he observed unilateral growth and also curvature of coleoptile. Unilateral growth. The unilateral, it is nothing but the growth that takes place only one direction towards the sources of light. He observed unilateral growth and also curvature of coleoptile. Coleoptile is nothing but shoot apex. The shoot actually it is a plumule part, that is a future plant body. Shoot become developed into plumule become developed into shoot system. The plumule part become, I mean it's covered by a layer sheathing, a layer is called coleoptile. So he observed, Charles Darwin in the year 1880 observed unilateral growth and also curvature of the coleoptile. Unilateral, it is nothing but the growth takes place only one directions, unidirections towards the source of light. But auxin synthesized in the tip of the root stem leaf. It is synthesized root tip, shoot tip and the leaf tip. Only the apex regions are synthesized by auxins. Where the evidence? How they are synthesized? It was observed by Charles Darwin. See, let us take diagram. It is apex. Shoot apex. So it is at tip regions. Shoot tip. Shoot tip. It is composed of meristematic cells, they are immature cells. That is the actual site for auxin synthesis. So auxins are synthesized in the root tip. But they are synthesized in one part, gets downward. From there migrated downwards. As a result, they cause elongation. I mean they are synthesized in the shoot tip or maybe root tip, from there migrated to the zone of elongation. As a result, these are the zone of elongations. It is auxin portion, shoot tip. It is a sources of auxin. Here the cells which is present in this zone, as the effect of auxin, the cells that become gets elongated. That become elongated. See, it is a normal shoot tip. The cells are shorter, smaller in size. But due to the presence of auxins are migrated to the zone of elongation, as a result, all these dividing cells are gets elongated, increase the length. That is why it shows curvature movement to the sources of light. So the shoot always grow towards the source of light. That is why it shows curvature movement. Always shoot grow towards the source of light. These are called positively phototropisms. So these are called phototrophic movement. Phototropism. The word tropism means movement towards the source of light. Phototropism. So from this experiment, Charles Darwin concluded, actually Charles Darwin observed unilateral growth. I mean the growth takes place only one direction, that shows towards the sources of light. He observed in the plant canary grass. Charles Darwin observed this unilateral growth observed in the plant is called, commonly called canary grass. It is one of the monocot plant, belongs to the family Poaceae. Poaceae. Its binomial name is Phalaris canariensis. Phalaris canariensis. So what is the binomial name of canary grass? It is one of the grass commonly called bird weed. It is a grass, belongs to the family Poaceae family. Poaceae family. Its binomial name is Phalaris canariensis. In these plants that shows curvature movement, it was observed by Charles Darwin in the year 1880. And finally, Charles Darwin came into conclusions. So there is some substances, something or that influences was translocated or transformed from the tip of the plant body towards the basal regions. The synthesis from tip and migrated towards the basal regions. These influences are laterally identified as auxin by Wendt. So how actually the observations action of what the actual role of auxins was find out by Charles Darwin. What he find out actually the something that influences that synthesized in the tip of the plant body, but he doesn't know it is a chemical name auxins, he doesn't know by Charles Darwin. But later this chemical substance actually is isolated and identified as a auxin by Wendt. The next we are going to discuss how Wendt to discovered auxins. He demonstrated the existence of and what the actual role of auxins in the plant. They conducted, they did a series of experiment by using Avena coleoptile, Avena plant. I mean it's actually a Wendt's plant. What's the binomial name of Wendt? Avena sativum. He took this plant for his experiment by Wendt. Wendt experiment. W. Wendt. He was a Dutch botanist, I mean biologist. He is the first person to demonstrate what are the occurrence of auxins. I mean existence and what the role, actual role or physiological role of auxins was demonstrated, first demonstrated by W. Wendt. And he did a series of experiment by using Avena sativum. Actually, it is a binomial name of Wendt's. And he observed this curvature movement and also what the action of auxins are synthesized in the root apex, observed in Avena coleoptile. Then what is called coleoptile? Coleoptile, it is a layer of cells that covering the shoot tip, I mean plumule part. The plumule part become developed into shoot system. It is a radical part become developed into root system in a embryo conditions. So the plumule part is covered by a layer of sheath or cells, these are called coleoptiles. It is a seed of Wendt's. What is the binomial name? Avena sativum. When the seeds are placed under the soil, it absorbs water by the process called imbibitions that becomes swell up, the seed coat become burst and the germination, I mean plumule part become gets germinated towards the sunlight. These are called positively phototropisms. These are the normal growth. But he took Avena sativum coleoptile for his experiment by Wendt actually. He did a three different type of experiment. In the first experiment actually, he removed the tip of the coleoptile. He removed, these are called detached part of the coleoptile. So this portion is called decapitated coleoptile. I mean the cut end or cut tip. These are the cut tip. It is a decapitated coleoptile. These are the tip of the coleoptiles. He observed after some times, after the decapitated, after the cut remove of this tip actually, he observed this. There is this end part, the cut end part, it does not show any growth. So because that indicate some chemical substances are synthesized or produced by the root tip that is responsible for the growth of the plant body. That is the reasons if they remove the tip actually, the growth does not take place in the cut tip. In second experiment, actually, he places agar block on the decapitated coleoptile. Then what is called agar block? It is a substance, I mean solid substance. Substance prepared from the, I mean obtained from the a red algae called Gelidium and Grasslaria. Gelidium and Grasslaria. It is actually red algae. From this red algae, to prepare, we have to prepare a substance, a solid substance is called agar block. It is obtained from the algae is called agar agar. That is extensively used in the plant tissue culture technology. That's we are going to study in higher class detailing how they are utilized in the plant tissue cultures. But this agar block actually prepared from the red algae is called Gelidium and Grasslaria. And went actually placed the agar block on the decapitated coleoptiles. But after some time, say this decapitated coleoptile, tip of the decapitated coleoptile, it does not shows any response. It's a second experiment. In the third experiment, actually, this decapitated or tip of the coleoptile is already removed. The tip of the coleoptile is actually placed on the agar block. It is agar block, it's a tip of the coleoptile placed on the agar block. It's a third experiment. In his next experiment, I mean third experiment, actually placed this tip of the coleoptile on the agar block. After 1 hour, after an hour, he discarded this tip. Actually, he discarded this tip of the coleoptile and he placed this agar block on the decapitated coleoptile, or also called the cut end of the coleoptile. He placed this agar block, and after this place, actually, after some times, he observed that this tip of the coleoptiles, that grows normally, they grow straight upwards. And from that experiment, he concluded, actually, certain chemical substance, somethings were synthesized in the tip. They are produced in the tips that were diffused into the agar block. Some chemical substance are produced or synthesized in the tip of the coleoptile that gets diffused into the agar block. That is responsible for the growth of the plant body. He concluded that. So, and finally, this chemical substance, it's nothing but auxin. That is why the auxin's name, it's nothing but to grow. The auxin's meaning to grow. So, it is a way to find out where the auxins are synthesized. Usually, auxin, it is a first plant hormone to be discovered. It is initially derived from the human urine of Bellagra patient. It is synthesized in the tip of the root stem leaf, only root apex, shoot apex only synthesized. What is the evidence? How to find out these auxins are synthesized in the root tip? It was first demonstrated by Wendt, W. Wendt. He was a Dutch biologist. He did a series of experiments by using Avena coleoptile. Avena sativum, it is a binom limb of oats plant. He took this plant for his experiment, and these are the various plants that shows different stages by using Avena curvature test. The next types of auxins. Auxins, already we know that it is the first plant hormone to be discovered, and based on these functions, various physiological functions and origin, the first hormone auxins are classified into two types. One is natural auxin. Auxins. Then second one is synthetic auxins. Auxins.
What is called natural auxins? These are the chemical substances or organic compound. They are synthesized very very minute quantity in one part of the plant, synthesized by plants themselves. These are called natural auxins. I mean, the chemical substances are synthesized by plants themselves. These are called natural auxins. For example of natural auxin, IAA, I mean indole 3 acetic acid. Indole 3 acetic acids. Then PAA, phenyl acetic acids. So these are the two examples for natural auxins. The natural auxins are synthesized by plant themselves in the tip of the root, shoot and leaf apex. Then what is called synthetic auxins? These are the artificially synthesized chemical substance in the laboratory condition. It is nothing but man-made substance. These are called man-made substance. The man-made substances are artificially synthesized. Synthesized in the laboratory condition, but they have the similar physiological effect of natural auxins. What are the natural auxins effect actually? They induce cell division, that's we are going to discuss now. What are the actual physiological effect of auxins? And in these artificial chemical substances or man-made substances that have the similar property of these natural auxins, but actually this is synthesis in the laboratory conditions. For example of these artificial auxins are also called synthetic auxins. NAA means naphthalene acetic acids. Naphthalene acetic acids. The second one is 2,4-D. I mean 2,4 dichlorophenoxyacetic acids. Dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. 2,4 dichlorophenoxyacetic acids. The third one is 2,4-5-T. I mean 2,4-5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acids. So these are the certain example for synthetic auxins. It is a man-made chemical substance. So based on these functions, I mean origin, there are two groups of auxins. One is a natural auxin, another one is a synthetic auxin. The natural auxins are synthesized by plants themselves. These are called natural auxin. For example, indole 3 acetic acids, commonly called IAA. Another one is a phenyl acetic acids, also called PAA. Then second one is a synthetic auxins. It is a man-made substance synthesized in the laboratory conditions actually. There are two types, I mean the, for example of these synthetic auxins, NAA, naphthalene acetic acid, and 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. Another one is 2,4-5-trichlorophenoxyacetic acids. The next topic we are going to discuss, what is the physiological effect of auxins? Physiological effect. So these auxins to bring about a several physiological effect in different parts of the plant body. So what are the physiological role, I mean functions, a different kind of functions are performed by auxin in different parts of the plant body. The first one is actually auxin promote the elongation of stem and coleoptile. It promotes elongation of stem and coleoptile by cell division and cell elongations. Generally, auxins are mainly responsible for inducing cell elongations. They are synthesized in the root tip. From there, migrated to the region of or zone of elongation. So, main functions of auxin to induce cell elongation, but partially it is also induced cell divisions. So, it promotes the elongation of stem and also coleoptile. We know that what is called coleoptile, it is a shoot covering portions. I mean, plumule covering portions called coleoptile. Shoot tip. So stem, how the stems are gets promoted, I mean they grow always towards the sources of sunlight by cell division, cell elongation, it was induced by auxins. So cell, one cells are divided into 2, 4, 8, likewise these are called geometric growth. But maximum plants, one cells are divided into 2 cells, among the 2 cells one cell they lost the power of division, that become meristematics, that become permanent. They lost the power of divisions. Remaining one cells are further divided into 2. Among the 2 cells, one is loss of division. So the result is SSL increasing 1, 2, 3, 4. These are called arithmetic growth. So in maximum plants, growth takes place in arithmetic region, I mean arithmetic state. Is the first physiologic effect. Then second physiologic effect of auxins, it promote the formation of root, I mean it induce root formation. Root, it is always grow towards the sources of earth, they grow towards the earth. So root, it is positively geotropism, negatively phototropism. The root always grow towards the earth. These are called geotropism. They won't grow towards the sunlight. So it is a positively geotropism, negatively phototropism. Due to the presence of auxin in the root tip, it induces root formations, especially at low concentration. That is a keyword. At low concentrations, auxin induces root formation, especially low concentration. At higher concentration, it always inhibits the growth of the root. Higher concentration inhibits the growth, I mean to stop the growth. Growth of root. This is a second physiological effect. Then third physiological effect actually, it causes apical dominance. What is called apical dominance? Auxins always produce in the tip region. They cause the promotions of tip towards the sunlight. That is called apical dominance. For better understand, let me draw a diagram here. Yes. It is apical bud, it is a lateral bud. The bud which is produced at the tip of the plant, these are called apical bud. The bud which is arises from the lateral sides and the axis of the leaf is called lateral bud. Auxins are produced on the apical bud, but due to the presence of auxin in the apical bud, it suppress the growth of the lateral bud. Suppress in the sense to inhibit the growth of the lateral bud by apical bud. Due to auxins are produced in the apical bud, these are called apical dominants. However, the lateral buds are growth on removal of apical bud. If you remove the apical bud, actually the auxins are migrated downwards to promote the growth of lateral bud. So these are called apical dominants. It's nothing, apical dominants nothing but to suppress the growth of lateral bud by apical bud. Due to auxins are produced in the apical bud, these are called apical dominants. So auxin always to cause apical dominance. The next to the physiological effect of auxin, auxin induced parthenocarpic fruit. dues parthenocarpic fruit. Then what is called parthenocarpic fruit? It is nothing but seedless fruit. Seedless fruits. Generally there are three types of fruit. One is a eucarp, or also called true fruit. True fruit, it is also called eucarp. And second one is pseudocarp, or also called false fruit. A pseudocarp. Third one is parthenocarpic fruit. These are the three types of fruit. What is called true fruit? It is also called U. The word U means true fruit. After true fertilization, the ovary part become developed into fruit, oval part become developed into seeds. That is called true fruit. For example, mango, it is an example for true fruit. In second category, false fruit, it is also called pseudocarp. The flower, fruit developed from any other part of the flower other than the ovary, either may be pedicel or thalamus, that become fleshy, juicy, succulent, that is the edible part. Take for example apple. The apple actually is a false fruit. It is also called pseudocarp. Why? Because the edible portion thalamus. What is called thalamus? Upper cup-shaped portions of the pedicel is called thalamus. Stalk of the flower is called pedicel. Upper part of the pedicel become swollen. These are called thalamus. The thalamus become elongated to enclose the entire ovary. So the true fruits are present within the ovary, but it's completely developed, elongated, enclosed by thalamus. So thalamus, it is a juicy and edible portion of apple. That is why the apple, it is an example for false fruit. False fruit is nothing but the fruit developed from any other part of the flower other than that of the ovary. Ovary part developed into fruit, that is called true fruit. Other than the ovary is called pseudocarp, are also called false fruit. Then parthenocarpic fruits. Actually, the fruits are formed without act as a fertilization. So generally, there are three types of fruits. One is a true fruit, false fruit, and parthenocarpic fruit. In true fruits, actually, it is also called eucarp. The fruits develop from the ovary part of the flower. These are called true fruit. False fruit, the fruit develop from any other part of the flower other than the ovary. These are called false fruit. It is also called parthenocarpic fruit, for example apple. It's also called pseudocarp. Then third one is parthenocarpic fruits, nothing but without act as a fertilization. But auxin induced parthenocarpic fruit, it is nothing but seedless fruits. For example of seedless fruit, watermelon, grapes, tomato, apple, lime. So these are the certain example for seedless fruit, also called parthenocarpic fruit. These are economically to value. Then another effect of auxin prevent abscissions. Then what is called abscission? Abscission is nothing but the process of separation of leaves, flowers, fruits from the plant body. These are called abscission. Shedding of leaves. The process of the, in certain plant actually, the fruits, leaves, flowers, they're shed prematurely from the plant body. Before their maturity, they're shedding. These are called abscissions. Separation of flowers is called abscission. But auxin, if you are spraying these auxins on this plant body, it prevents premature falling.
premature falling.
Usually, before maturation, certain parts of the flowers, plants actually, they are shed. These are called abscissions. But auxin prevent abscissions. I mean, they prevent the premature falling. For example, of mango. Then another one effect of auxin, it eradicate weed. Eradicate weed in the field. In the field. For example, 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid. In 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, it is a synthetic auxins or man-made substance. These man-made substances used as a weedicide are also called herbicides. Herbicides in the sense to kill the herb, to remove the weed. Then what is called herbs? Herbs, it is an unwanted plant. They are unnecessarily growing in the crop field. For especially rice crop or sugarcane field, they are unnecessarily growing this herb. How to remove the herb? How to remove? By using certain chemical substance. If you are applying this chemical substance, for example 2,4-dichlorophenoxyacetic acid, to kill the weed, that is why it is also called weedicide or also called herbicide to kill the herb. Herb is also called weed. Weed is nothing but unwanted plant. So these chemical substance, that is auxin, which is used to eradicate the weed in the field. So these are the visual effect and conclusion my teaching today. The physical effect today, what we are discussing, that's a plant hormone. It is one of the chemical substances are synthesized by the plants themselves. These are called plant hormone. They are broadly classified into 5 groups: auxin, gibberellin, cytokinin, ethylene, and also abscisic acids. And auxin is the first plant hormone to be discovered. And what are the effect of auxins? How they are synthesized? Where it is synthesized in the plant body? Then what are the effect of in another body? Who is first discovered auxins? Vent, other things we discuss now. In next videos, we are going to discuss another 4 more plant hormones such as cytokinin, gibberellin, abscisic acid, and ethylenes.